name, date of birth, where you were born, what states have you had identification in, have you ever had held a U.S. passport, have you been in the U.S. military, what is your social security number, what is your mother's maiden name, have you ever been in prison, wrote up all the questions, printed out a bunch of the forms, went and bought a clipboard, went and got a little plastic badge and put my face on the badge, and it said, you know, Salvation Army, and it had some made up name. So I put it on my belt, and I took my little, you know, clipboard with my sheets, and I went out and I drove around until I found a bunch of homeless guys.
Do you see?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of Nerd Chronicles. Excuse me. This is your host, Proud Lane, certified beta male simp mangina. Whatever it is with no game, the socially awkward nerd Christian Paul is in the building, ladies and gentlemen.
Do you see?
And just when you think things didn't really pass my luck, all of a sudden it went downhill. Ladies and gentlemen. It was crazy. Because this happened literally on my 32nd birthday, around a couple days ago, around the time of this recording, and I find out I get hired from a very serious company, doing all the research, thinking that it was legit. As you see, you have all the forms is up there. You know, the personal address is basically, basically have to fold it up, you know, for private, personal reasons and protective reasons here. You know, you seen all these options here, all these requirements y'all see up here. Basically, everything looks like an offer sheet that you normally would see. That, you know, you would think, you know, the company would actually do it themselves and actually get all the stuff signatured out and everything. You would think that, right? Only to find out that it's a possible assault behind the scenes that's looking to steal your identity, looking to steal all the money that you have. They could try to lease off you, buy the stuff off you, and get yourself framed. Pardon my language, by the way, and I'll just basically edit it how it may be. And unfortunately, I basically learned the hard way. Ladies and gentlemen, what you are dealing with is a new age of scamming, a new age of grifting, a new age of that's what I said. The new age of fraud, right? I tell y'all, the new age of grifting is utilizing any form of real life company that's basically vulnerable, that doesn't have a structured system on who runs their stuff. And a lot of thieves would mainly use it for the advantage, just so you actually try to leech on your identity and get yourself used up and spits you out. And it's not just happening within like the data science field, even though data science is one of the hottest landing jobs literally up in the country right now, but yet it's so sparse and so dense and so wide and literally varies between company to company a bit, depending on what the requirements mainly are. Applicants could be very vulnerable at that point. Do all these thieves are actually looking to steal anything from them and looking to steal money from them, so that they ain't trying to buy some stuff and take all the stuff, however it may be, whether it's like bank accounts, checking accounts, however it may be. But little do they know, they dealing with folks that are actually very, very smart what they do and have very smart backgrounds and how they handle their stuff and how they handle their logistics, however it may be. And many of these groups they see doing this type of stuff are stupid. They really are. And one of the big signs I really want to point out, the trick of the matter is actually literally trying to find it, how it literally takes place. Yes, this right here may look a little bit real, but you have to pick up these types of signs in order to fully sniff them out, right? And a big sign of this, and I'm probably going to rate them from like the least dangerous to like the most dangerous, right? Number one, the lowest of them all mainly is dealing with uniform email addresses. If the email address is mainly not uniform, It's possible you're dealing with a small business, or you could be dealing with a charlatan. There's a lot of small businesses that use various emails to allow other workers to have their personal emails and where they actually do their jobs at times, make sure they actually get some of the stuff in. But usually when companies, they will actually use their website's email so that they'll be able to utilize within the same system and actually communicate with one another whether or not and how things are mainly done. That basically would be a key in the whole ordeal. If you may send somebody, that would be like another thing that's a little high up on the list. If you see someone that's actually trying to rush you and trying to take the job and getting yourself all prepped up immediately, you may want to take it a little bit with a grain of salt. But this is the biggest one, okay? I received something from the email of a chat by a self-proclaimed recruiter that they claim to be, that's actually masked as a recruiter, that basically says back then our company actually used to purchase some stuff from vendors so that we'll be able to send the stuff to you. But because they said that they're not able to actually no longer do all that stuff due to conflicts and arguments and disagreements, we now require all new employees to take a photo of checks that we send through email or actual checks and actually deposit in the banks that will tell you what to buy from our vendors. Biggest red flag that you need to actually have your antennas up right now. Because in a normal company setting, right, they were not asked to do these types of things. They would actually provide the stuff really for you automatically, have that shipped out without you ever paying a dime. If they have issues with one vendor, all they can easily do is actually just go speak with another vendor and make a deal with that vendor so that they can have the stuff shipped out while they pay the vendors the type of money to ship out their work materials and their work items in order for people to literally work remotely and have them mailed up to the employee's place of residence, right? So that ain't normal. And you know, I did the whole check thing, did everything they said, and even like the top-notch banks like Chase, PNC Banks, they sniffed that stuff out as fraudulent because they checked the remaining accounts from the other end. They say it's not fully valid. That's what made things actually very well, even though like the recruiter may claim that saying, hey, it's not gonna decline and all that stuff. Chase says BS, right? And the moment I actually posted posted the screenshot of the check actually declining, she sounded a bit flabbergasted. And right before then, she was claiming, saying once the check is in the process of actually confirming, if it's a little bit late, you need to actually put up $600 at least toward the vendor so that you'll be able to actually get ready to work literally on time, which is actually very odd and very, very abnormal. If you see any recruiter that tells you to put up money of your own just to actually get the items that you need to get, run, go seek a litigation attorney, speak with them about the matter, stop what you're doing. If you see the location, speak to them in person, see what the heck is going on, but make sure you speak to a litigation attorney about this matter because it could be a lawsuit literally waiting to happen to the point where they could contact your local state AG on this issue, which could be very serious and can actually affect your long-term future if you're literally not careful. All right. So I eventually did check the recruiter. You know, I had some words and I had some discreet words. And basically what I said, why not get the recruiter? I basically tried to validate my appointment and all of a sudden I got blocked, and that's how I knew, boom, it was a scam. So I want to try and warn you guys a heads up, because I know there's like a lot of data scientists, content creators out there that may not be privy to this type of information, that may warn others basically on this type of knowledge here. And please take my word and heed my words very seriously. Vet the companies that you're trying to apply for jobs. I understand it can be very difficult at times dealing with all these crazy applications, with all these weird experiences that they're actually looking to seek. Even though you're building your own stuff before, there are a lot of charlatans that will be lurking in the woods on your LinkedIns, on your Gmails, on your Glassdoor accounts, knowing that you're looking at you trying to get a job that's actually with serious pay, and then looking to bait on your vulnerability, just like what many of those red pill gurus are mainly doing towards you. All these extreme modern feminists are actually doing it to the folks who actually create a pinpoint of pain and emotion and vulnerability just so they can try to literally make a grift and make a profit off of your misery. All right. And with that being said, y'all please be more careful. Y'all share the video. This type of stuff is extremely important. And, you know, the vibe and health thing, that's basically what it is that you're trying to mimic off. We see y'all. We see what y'all trying to do. You know, all that screenshots of what y'all doing is basically over. You know what I'm saying? We see what you're doing. We ain't stupid. I ain't stupid. Okay? This would be some forewarning to those that literally apply for appealing jobs. To be very careful of them leeches. And to be extremely careful of those charlatans.
Scammers who are trying to steal your personal information are just getting smarter and more sophisticated by the day. I'm going to tell you some of the most common ways that people discover they're victims of identity theft and how you can protect yourself. Many people either don't recognize or they ignore signs that they are victims of ongoing identity theft. If left unaddressed, it can lead to catastrophic consequences. So here are four signs to keep in mind that indicate you might be the victim of identity theft. Unexpected credit card denials, surprisingly high interest or insurance rates, receiving collection notices for accounts that you don't recognize, reviewing credit reports, and seeing accounts that are not your own. So when you catch these signs early, it can be the difference between a small loss and one that's disastrous. What you want to do is periodically review your credit reports for information that you don't recognize, and pay attention to the activity on all your open accounts.
Do you see?